Hello everybody, welcome to a new Legacy video. I'm playing today Uvu Shark still. Not really a deck that I love to play my Legacy video with, because it's a pretty slow one, but you know, I just was looking through the top 8 finishes of the Legacy Challenge, and this deck's kinda clicked in me, maybe because I'm loving the blue-white flyers in old school, and there's a copy of Moat. Although in paper, Moat is slightly more expensive than online. Online, no, reserve list doesn't exist, and Moat is 93 cents. Online is different, so, you know. We're clearly playing a digital platform here, where we can add a powerful enchantment like this to shut off the opponent's ability to attack you, basically. Some decks are entirely shut off by this card, and it's a pretty sweet one to have. We can fly over it with Shark Typhoon. I'll answer it immediately. How does this deck win? That's usually the question that blue-white control players receive the most. And the answer is just Shark Typhoon. You'll make a shark, and you'll attack your opponent with. Ideally, you have a standstill down first, so that they can cast anything, while you get the advantage from the party situations that you put in by casting your turn 2 standstill. Just Don't Sculpture, of course, can also win with its ultimate. This deck might take a while. I know I'm risking starting this Legacy video, but you know, I'm down for it. This deck plays Hall of the Aliel's Generosity, which is a sweet new land. Doesn't have any creature land. This can put on top a Shark Typhoon, can put on top a standstill. That's a sweet card. Deck plays a lot of basics. There isn't Astrolabe to fix those. You just have Patience and basic land. I was thinking about adding snow covered lands because I've said how if you don't have snow cover lands, you automatically tell your opponent that you aren't playing Ice Fang Quaddle. And usually whenever I see my opponent starting off with basic island, I put them on combo decks. And we can just level that by playing a control deck without snow covered island, because, you know, that's something. Maybe that's wrong, and I should still have snow covered islands, because my opponent might play around a Quaddle if I have, like, no islands, no plains, and fetch land. They might play around Quaddle, but I don't know. I figured that also having some beautiful Anni-H basics is something nice. What else? Nothing really. This is just a blue-white control. Pretty straightforward. We even have a 2 counter spell. So yeah, this deck would be definitely be pretty long one to play in a tournament. So Duke 12 really did it by playing this deck in a 9-round tournament to a top 8 finish. From the Ashes is a cool card in the sideboard. It's basically a one-sided Armageddon. Always a card that I love to play whenever I was toying with Miracles. This deck obviously isn't Miracles. So he does no Miracles, in fact. The Supreme Verdict over Terminus 2. Stony Silence is for the Mono Blue Echo deck. Rest in peace. Wait, no, I can't play this Art of Disenchant. There is a limit to everything. You know, I don't mind the Moat, but yeah. Gotta use the sweet Disenchant at least. Torpor Orb, this is for Tassa's Oracle. That's a sweet one, because Tassa's Oracle, if you play this against Doomsday, they really have a tough time beating it. If they don't, they might even just be called to it, just die, because they can't trigger the Tassa Oracle. Some Elemental Blasts, and then we have 1 Surgical and 2 Flux of Storm. Quite straightforward deck, and I am excited to try it out in a Legacy League. Remembering that this video is sponsored by Channel Farmable Tom and the Ultimate Guard, please check out the CFB Pro deals and the sweet Ultimate Guard ways of protecting your cards, such as Katana Sleeves, Ultimate Guard, Perfect Sleeves, and of course the Sidewinder deck boxes. Round 1 with Uvu Shark still. I have to keep this one. Let's start with I think I'm gonna start by deck thinning as early as turn 1. I want to slow roll those Prismatic Vista though. Opponents on 6, okay. I'll just go Scalding Tarngo. In the main deck, there's no mountains. Sorry, no red cards. So the mountain is mostly for the sideboard from the Ashes and Red Elemental Blasts. Let's see where we are. Let's see what we are up against. Strub. Yeah, I'll just do a upkeep. Fetch lands, and I'll just slam the standstill with Island Plains, let's say. there's like a thin chance where my opponent is on Infect and they have Ink Moth Nexus that punishes my standstill. But it's just most likely that my opponent will either counter the standstill or will just have to pop it off if they play like a Maverick deck or whatnot. Could play. Definitely not Elves, because, you know, Elves always has a one drop, so let's see what it is. Veil of Summer, sure. Main deck Veil of Summer in a green-white deck is something. Veil of Summer usually is playing in control in combo decks in the main deck. So there might be a combo deck with Savannah, though. That's just strange. Maybe taking that Plains was stupid there because they have Ponder and Brainstorm in my hand. Should have just probably taken another island, but we'll see how it goes. When it goes with Wasteland, pass. So now our goal is just to hit land drops. I have nowhere to go, so I just keep on land drops. You don't have to cast any spell because you have Standstill, which says that whenever a player casts a spell, your opponent resolves an Ancestral Recall. If you do, sacrifice it. You have to sacrifice the Standstill, and your opponent draws three cards. Ooh, yeah, that's another way. I didn't think about it. Thespian Stage Dark Depths is another way to punish the Standstill for free, in the sense that your opponent will be able to just naturally make a 2020. Standstill is an old card. It's not a 2021 card. Wow, they actually have it. Oh, this is definitely a screenshot worthy play. You know how I love to do my... This is definitely a screenshot worthy. You know, it's 2021, I register Standstill, and my opponent just has the natural combo. Okay, so here, I'm likely to just... Oh, it's sad. I mean, basically they'll draw... Yeah, I mean, I think I have to pass here. I can't pop off the Standstill like that. If they do the thing, I'm going to plow it. And I mean, if they have a Knot of this World, they get me good. But I'm hoping they don't have it. This is very funny. The opponent makes a 2020, and I have to plow or else I die. So opponent draws three cards. All right. That's definitely funny. Way to begin this stream. We don't care about their life total. They're all gonna win on control. So, who cares? They aren't 39. Oof. I think... It might have been a mistake to register this league, but... We'll see what happens here. Alright, Elvish Reclaimer. That resolves. We have two Supreme Verdict. As a sweeper. We basically exchanged it. Four cards for two lands. Oh, wow, that too. So, we have access to six forces right now and two counter spell. Yeah, I just have to brainstorm here, I think. I do have Narset. But they have those Elvish Reclaimer now. So, I certainly want to get rid of a Standstill. Do we want to just do this? Let the Sylvan Library resolve and hope to hold the Sylvan Library down with the Narset. You know what? I think I'll try and do that. So Prismatic Vista shuffles the top. I'm gonna get Island and Brainstorm again, end of turn. We have another fetch land to get rid of whatever I do not want. I actually want all of these cards. I'll just plow this Reclaimer, play Narset, pick up the top card of my deck. Which I guess could be a Ponder, just to tell my opponent nothing about my hand. Ponder gives no information. So what I do is here is plow this Reclaimer, play Narset, whose passive ability will shut off Sylvan Library's ability, and I'll be able to get... actually getting another plow. It's my third plow, by the way. Moat doesn't do much against the Dark Depths combo, but we can just chump block. I can just chump block with Shark Typhoon and then bounce the token with Jace. With Jace. Bazooka Bog. Do I have any... I mean, this resolves. I don't play Mystic Sanctuary, and I don't play any... Just any graveyard strategy, actually. I mean, Hall of the Old's Generosity is the only one I can think of. Sure. They know about my plow. And Bill Summer doesn't play around it. Zenith for zero. Okay, how many planes does this deck play? Two. Fine. I'll untap and draw. Minus two Narset, or maybe just want to fetch first. Yeah, I'll fetch first, get the planes down, and then minus two Narset. Now the two cards that were back in the deck, the bottom of my deck are back. Spellsnare doesn't look so bad. Constant Judgment doesn't look bad either. I'm taking Spellsnare though. And then I'll play a Wrath of God. I think Spellsnare is good. I mean, I'm sure my opponent has some annoying two drops. Force of Negation was also nice, but I already have a Force of Will in hand. I don't think I need more. Knight of the Reliquary. So here, I kind of want to use this plow to deal with the Reliquary. So I might just force pitch Spellsnare. Or I can actually just let his resolve and just plow. That's probably better. Although I just untap. I don't want to fetch for a Tundra end of turn. Basically, I don't want to pitch Spellsnare right now. Sure, my opponent can like assemble the Dark Depths Taspian Stage combo, but again, that takes a while because they don't have any lands that do these things, and I have a Shark Typhoon Chumblock plus Jace at my disposal. I have one Plows left only, but that's okay, I think. I'll just simply Harkas Force here. I want to look at their list up quickly. I believe that's the just the green-white Reclaimer deck that Wara won one of the first Legacy Challenge with, and our content creator Rich Kali wrote a deck guide about. So I'm just opening CFB and seeing Rich Kali's deck guide. Does my opponent have any way to deal with a Shark Typhoon? There's Cataclysmic Apparition. That's almost it. Whereas they have a lot of they have four plows. So I think I'll just cast this Typhoon here. Force of Negation backup, now that I top decked it. So now I'm just gonna take a slow route, but you know, every turn, my opponent is shut off from using their library. I don't have an answer to Knight of the Reliquary, but I do have an answer to Zenith, Greensand Zenith. Which they play in four copies. Wish Reclaimer is fine. Knight of Autumn. Yeah, they have one Knight of Autumn. I missed it. All right. The dogma that's never right to Harkas Shark Typhoon sticks. Even knowing the list, I managed to miss that, so that sucks. That would have been so nice if I just had a cycling card instead of. Ooh, very bad, very bad, very bad. Okay, I'm just gonna go Jace. And I think I'm drawing, hoping to draw the last plow. Moat. Huh, Moat isn't bad. Unfortunately, I can't defend my Jace, but Moat isn't bad. I'm certainly bottoming a land. And I think it's gonna be Spellsnare. Our opponent knows about it. Like, yeah. This way I can Arcast the two things if I want to. So now I'll lose the Jace. They have Cataclysmic Apparition for Moat. Four Skyclave, two Skyclave. If they had Skyclave though, they would have cast it on this Narset, because it's definitely stopping their business. I'm assuming that with both a knight. Oh wow, they diversify actually, two and one. to kill them both. Yeah, I didn't expect. All right, yeah, I mean, that makes sense. I only have one plow left. And they pass. Upkeep shuffle, now their library is active. At 47 life, library active will be a pain. Unless I draw. I was hoping to draw. I was hoping to draw a Narset, but that didn't happen. I just needed to brainstorm Dairy Jace. I was looking for answers. You know, our casting Shard Typhoon is probably wrong, but honestly, I had Force of Negation for Zenith. Even if I knew that at least only had one Night of Autumn, I think it was still the correct choice. It just didn't. Just didn't work, you know. Must be said that this game started with my opponent drawing three extra cards because of my card. That was a clean -4. -4ing yourself on turn four isn't the recipe for the victory, I can tell you that one. Opponent can't attack, but that's no big deal. I'll just get the combo going eventually and make a 20-20 flyer, which I don't have any answer as of now. Wow, opponent misses land drop. I wonder what their hand is. Gadakthig. Let me see what my deck is. Yeah, I mean, I can't cast Force of Will. J, Supreme Verdict, Moat. I mean, I guess I'm countering this one. Shark Typhoon, you can cycle still, but... Ooh, this is not bad. Can top. Can put on top of my deck a Shark Typhoon. To Chomp Block with. They have a wasteland. But at least I have a Shark Typhoon on top of my deck. Which I probably just are casting. Huh? Yeah. I think so. Alright. Weird that they chose Dark Depths. Cause that if they choose Thespian Stage, they can't immediately make a 20-20 next turn. Because this one makes it land tapped. Two, yeah, that's weird. Maybe they have like, I don't know. They were expecting me to, oh, that doesn't end naturally? No, they drew it now. Anyway, I am putting on top of Shark Typhoon, which I'll be drawing. I'll be using to... And I'll be using to cycle to make a token to then chump block the Thespian Stage. Do I want to do it now? What are my outs? Jace? Is Jace any good? No, probably just it's just plow at this point. I'm just on mono outs or supply shares. So I'm just making Baby Shark. Yeah, so it is resolves. I'm making 1/1 Baby Shark. Looking to see if I see a plow not in my opponent's tapped out with the Reclaimer. I'm sure they play Sejiri Step, so I think I have to act now. Shark Typhoon for 1. Looking for a plow or a brainstorm into a plow, keeping up counterspell. All right, I'll pass here. Positive, my opponent will just get the Sejiri Step. And kill me with the Marilege. Alright, this was a good game, honestly. I think it all went down when I put a Night of Autumn to my Shark Typhoon, which was really all I had. Oh, they can also correct as their Marilege back to hand. That's a legal play. Yeah, that plays. Another plow, Sylvan Safe Keeper. Sacrifice a land, target creature gains indestructible. Sorry, target creature gains X-proof. Or rather, Shroud. Alright, I'll concede to this one, good game. was a really good game, honestly. Shrub wins. Good game, Shrub. Opponent has Choke. Oosh. Carpet of Flowers. Yeesh. It's annoying. Alright, Disenchant. From the one and only Ashes. What do we cut? You know, I can't really have a standstill. Like, there's just no way I can cast a standstill. You've seen what happened. Guess a lot of Flossus Swarm. I might want Rest in Peace. No, alright. That just shrinks only a Reclaimer and Reliquary. I think if I just do that, it's... Can't really win. Torpor Orb. Torpor Orb shuts off Night of Autumn, Night of the... Nah, it's just not good enough as well. Yeah, just one Flossus Storm. Let's go. On the play against Green White Reclaimer. By the way, it's kind of funny how... So, you know how me and Anzi, we both make legacy videos. And every time, in order to not overlap, we talk to each other. And I told him that I would have played my opponent deck. And then I saw this deck, and I'm like, ah, I kind of want to switch. So I ended up just, you know, playing this over my opponent's deck of this first turn. So it's quite funny. If I lose, it was definitely a wrong choice. I decided to keep this hand. I have two ways to deal with my opponent Choke and the Carpet of Flowers, which I'm sure my opponent will bring in. I do have also Caracas, which is good. I'm not going to use it until it's very much needed. Ooh, okay. I definitely don't want to disenchant the Mox. There's more things I'm prioritizing right now. Just play a bunch of basics, no biggie. No rush. Oh, wow, no land. I'd love to see that. Whereas I don't fetch, I don't even think, I don't want to reduce the odds of drawing lands. I'm in the Drago situation right now. I mean, this deck kind of plays the Drago situation, it doesn't really do much else. I'm gonna play Caracas if I don't draw land. Okay, I did. The deck plays From the Ashes plus sideboard. So you can't, you have to take. Ooh. Cast Force of Negation. Pick up Island, and I'll pick up, I think, Plains. Opponent will go Veil of Summer. I just realized this. Why do I think of that? They drew land, so they were just holding mana for Veil of Summer. Maybe I should just... I'm just supposed to just go disenchant at this point. But technically, I want to keep disenchant for... if I go disenchant, they go land choke. I guess I'll go Constant Judgment there. It's a tough deal, you know. What am I gonna do? Never cast a counterspell anymore because I have one mana up. Yeah, I mean I might. Okay, this resolves. I don't go disenchant. Shouldn't have overfetched. Okay. I mean, maybe there's a situation where I go 8 mana, Force of Negation, Force of Will, if the game gets slow enough. This definitely is gonna be a slow video. maybe I will not record the full 5 matches. I wish Reclaimer. That's fine. Maybe I can let them do the Reclaimer thing, like... It's not that bad. Oh, this is... Nothing happens here. I'm playing around the real summer. And sure, they have a reclaimer that will exchange their savanna for whatever they want. Okay, yeah, two Supreme Verdict in my deck. I should probably have a second Flusser's Throne in the deck. Dread Arbor. Yeah, I'm definitely looking for that Supreme Verdict now. I'll put a D to use end of turn activation. Strange, right? Just hit my 8th land drop on turn 9. I've not drawn a cantrip yet. I'm not slowing land drops. I want to play them all because I can't go Force of Negation plus Force of Will plus a Storm. I might thin my deck now. I guess I'm thinning. My deck will be very thin. Very thin now. Certainly never drawing a land anymore. As, kind of like the good old, like, you fetch, draw, fetch land. You know, kind of like, you know that. Also, I don't understand why my opponent doesn't top this, but, they have, like, oh, you know why? Because they have a Sejiri step up this way. Sure. Not for that. Oh, I'll get a Plains now. Just shaking things up. Ooh, El Tifón! Not casting it, right? What to say? Am I casting it? Alright, let's take a look at their deck again. So they have Force of Vigor in the sideboard, maybe. A main deck, Knight of the Ultimate, we saw it. So let's say I tap out for Shark Typhoon. And, yeah, I think I'm risking. I think I'll put my life at risk again. I'll put my life at risk again. Let's go. Casting a Typhoon. Your turn, opponent. I have six cards, five of them are counter magic. Every counter magic I cast will create a shark. Force of Will, 5/5 shark. Force of Negation, 3/3 shark. Flusser Storm, tiny shark. Okay, Wasteland, sure. They can now take a weird, sorry, not a weird, a good approach actually, which is just Wasteland, fetch land, attack for 7. I prefer to bluff the plow rather than, because maybe now they attack only for 4. Keeping up the reclaimer to pretend to play around my plow. I don't even have a tundra in my deck, I think, at this point. But yeah, so I take 4 down to 7. Next turn I'll go Council of Judgment. Sejiri's step doesn't protect them from Council of Judgment, which is cool. Okay, something is happening. Choke. I'm not gonna get choked here. I'm not going to get choked. You better believe. You better believe that. So here I have to go Force of Will, pitching Force of Negation. I'll make a 5/5 shark, much better than 3/3 shark. Yeah. They go Veil of Summer. I go Flusser Storm. Make a 1/1 shark. Same target, same target, same target, same target. Now, we don't choke, we very well breathe and then top all our lands. I'll play a Council of Judgment here. Exiling a reclaimer. And then I want to attack for 5 here. can double block this one, and they have two counter magic backup. I haven't tapped any island in case, you know, we don't, I don't need to, I don't want to get choked. Night of Autumn, that's funny. I think I'll pay 5 for a Force of Will here. Make it 5/5 Shark. Go Veil of Summer, I go Force of Negation. Alright, good game. Shark Typhoon wins. Sideboard. I think I am going to add a Flusty Storm. I think I'm going to add a Flusty Storm since it's been really good against Veil of Summer, which I'm expecting my opponent to be on right now. Like, they've even cast the Flusty Storm game one, and I'm expecting them to have maximized in game two. So, Spellsnare counters Sylvan Library, which is nice. Yeah, I'm sideboarding out From the Ashes. Maybe that's just too good, though. Maybe Moat. Maybe Moat doesn't fit the deck. That, like, I mean, I'm sure there's a spot where Knight of the Reliquary beatdown is a thing. I guess that just happens, though, right? That just happens. I don't really want to cut blue cards. I'm a pretty big fan of having blue cards around. Huh. Although Moat is kind of clunky. If your opponent has a way to break the Moat, it's just not that good. Like, not just break the Moat with the Knight of Autumn, just break the Moat with, like, Marid Lage in this case. Yeah, I think I'll cut the Moat. Let's go. Keep. Pretty happy with the turn one spells in the air on the library. If they go Mox Diamond, they can cast turn one library. Although I'm ready with a couple of forces. Yeah, Elvish Reclaimer. Very powerful, very strong. I'll just go Lango here. We have to respect the library. Don't need to ponder too. Like, sure, I'll just get. Don't want a Reclaimer end of turn. Welcome to do so. Attacking me, sure. I mean, it's a 1-2. A Nordwood Ranger right now. Two Nordwood Ranger right now. Huh. Yeah, I think I cast Ponder. I'm looking for lands here. Perfect. I love all of these cards. Do I drutter? I think I'd rather draw lands. Yeah, I just want to draw lands here. I want to draw a couple of lands. I don't want to fetch next turn either, so we'll see what happens. Now I'm able to cast spells in air on their library. Flusty Storm will mostly be a. I don't. Might happen that I force a good creature, like a Knight of the Reliquary. And with the Mox, they can go by the Summer and have Flusty Storm up. But yeah, they need three creatures in the graveyard. Surely they can. You can go fetch, activate one, reclaimer, but. Yeah, they just take his lower route, which I love. I love they're taking his lower route to this game. Nice, they just passed the turn back. And doing the same here, no rush. No rush at all. They have the Sejiri step up. So they don't even activate the Reclaimer end of turn. Thank God they didn't have a third fetch land. So they can't attack me for three. They keep on chipping in for one. I'll draw the top card, which is a Shark Typhoon. They're casting a choke. I mean, I have to counter or else I die. I'll pitch spells near. Could have pitched a Force of Will. We have Summer, we have the Flusser Storm. Then I'll draw the card from the top of my deck here. Which will... which I might be able to cycle as a 2-2 to block the Reclaimer to prompt some actions on their side next turn. They have two cards. Draw the shark, play land, pass the turn. I don't even know how many basic land they play. They play just like very few basics, like three. Okay, so this is a 3-4 now. But... I guess I'm just chump blocking with a 1-1. Oh, maybe. I mean, that will fetch regardless here. So I just chump block with a 1-1, I think. Yeah, maybe I should have fetched force over the spells near. Because now if I had a window to make a one drop. I didn't think about this window. Ooh, that's a good one. Actually, I might just take the damage here. Because next turn I'm able to go Jace, bounce one. And chump block the other. I'm really hoping they don't cast a 2-drop here. Because that would make my play really bad. The one of having pitched the spells near. But usually you get punished when you play Magic and make decisions like that. It's just whole, it's like, it's kind of crazy, right? Isn't it crazy? But it always happened. It always happened. Anyway, we have to force. Cause, I mean, I can't work against the Labyrinth in this matchup. They have one card in hand. Draw. Prismatic Beast. Yeah, I got onto 7 and Jace bounce. Oh, I think I'll get a Plains, sure. Jace bounce a Reclaimer. And then I can chump block the other Reclaimer. And if it doesn't go right, we lost Jace. But I think this is the play to make. The next turn and tap Brainstorm with a Fetchland up. Plus I have a Flood of Strain and a card in hand. It might be a Plow. I haven't drawn a Plow in these two games. Drawn them all in the first game. Okay, looks like we're chumping here. We are, in fact, able to chump here. That's good. Mm-hmm, that's fine. And they pass. Nice. Nice. Draw. Oh, From the Ashes. Oh, that's not my priority now. My priority now is a Brainstorm and a Supreme Verdict. Yeah, it's pretty bad. Alright, what do we do? Just cast From the Ashes. I'm what, dead on board? Huh, not really, but... I guess I'm just cycling a Shark Typhoon. Yeah, right? Okay, what do we bottom here? From the Ashes Mountain. Cycle Shark Typhoon with Hollow Valley of Generosity. Yeah, right? That looks like a play to me. I kind of want to keep Counterspell around. Don't really care about From the Ashes. It does, like, blow up two lands because they got planes. Yeah, that's not good enough. All right. Play land, pass the turn. Wasteland. Okay. A Shark Typhoon in my graveyard, but it doesn't matter. I just need to use the... Just need to use the mana here to cycle a 4-4 Shark Typhoon. Might have not get the Volcanic Island because now they can tap the Reclaimer to get a Wasteland and Wasteland me. But then that means that they don't attack me, which is good, of course. Like, they might just trade Reclaimer for a Jace by attacking if they don't have anything. I said to get the Volkier in case I draw from the ashes that I want to cast. Oh, they got Sejiri's Step. Oh, that's yeah, considered this. Yeah, but I couldn't really do anything, I think. Like, if I let them Wasteland me. Maybe what I could have done was to get Mountain instead of the Hole, but it didn't have Wasteland. Yeah, right, they didn't have Wasteland. Sure, one card left for them. Also, Hall is good if they don't have Wasteland. I mean, I think it was good to go the Hole. Anyway, I'm passing with my Shark, dead on board currently. Of course, we're not gonna tell them that I'm dead on board. And they didn't believe me, so they just kill me. Alright, I think this was a good game. The only difference that could have happened is that I could have had a Forceful for the end instead of just not having it. Yeah, I think overall I just died because I didn't do anything. That's just a simple reason. Deck just flooded out terribly. Alright. If you guys have fun in this first game, I'll be back for round number two. Game number one of this round number two after a pretty sweet first match. You know, we ended up losing, but it was indeed a pretty sweet match against the Green White Reclaimer deck. Here, I'll just kick things off with a Ponder. Mostly looking for, I'm guessing a Plow. Standstill, maybe, actually. Yeah, I wouldn't mind playing Standstill on top of my deck. Yeah, I feel like I can't really shuffle these, right? I'll draw all three. I'll draw the Spellsnare first to be able to counter a T-drop. Ooh, Planes go. Okay, then. I'll go Skullintarn. Go here. Let's see what we're facing. I doubt it is the mirror match. I'm drawing the land there. And I think I'm jamming Narset. Force of Negation, Pitching Predict. Wow, it could actually be the mirror. Just predict. Yeah, I think I'll go Force of Will, Pitching Spellsnare. Nice. Immediately looking for another Force here. Ooh, a Standstill. Yeah, I think I'll play it. Sorry, I think I'll pick it. It's better than two other cantrips. And if I stick the Narset around, they can't really do much. Even if I pop up my own Standstill because they play a bigger Shark, they can't really draw extra cards, so. Yeah, this must be the mirror match. Oof. Wow, this is gonna be long. Or maybe not. Monster Mentor. Alright, it's not the mirror match. Let's see if I find the Plow immediately. Plow. Nice. Oh wow, they have a Force. Yeah, that's good. Force Pitch Snapcast from Mage. I'll play land and pass the turn. They have two cards in hand. I think I'll cycle Baby Shark and block the Monk there. In doubt if I need to take a Plains or... I guess I'm taking Tundra. It's the most impossible opponent plays a Wasteland in that deck. And here I'm just happy to do this. Like, if they Plow this, sure. They diversified? They didn't think about the Shark, I guess. Wow. It's crazy good for me now. Alright, I'll go Brainstorm first. That's so great, he's attacked me for two there. I'll go Brainstorm first. I think I'm just... I mean, at the end of the day, I don't have to... Okay, what I can do here is... Standstill Force. Then I cast a Standstill, and I play Swords. Oh, maybe Standstill... Standstill... Because Spellsnare might be good, I don't know. Spellsnare, I mean. I do kind of want to cast the Standstill too after I plow this. But I don't want to lose the Shark Typhoon or the Jace. Alright, let's do this. But I really hope I don't have to shuffle. Oh wow, the Force of Negation. Oh, Counterspell. Okay. So here, I cannot play Standstill, or maybe I still do it. Who knows here? I cast Standstill, and I have a larger Shark Typhoon. Lots of mana. I mean, I'm shuffling away a Jace, which is awkward, but yeah, I think I'm actually doing it. Playing Standstill when behind is awkward, but I do have a Shark Typhoon to cycle next turn. And the opponent might even actually be afraid of wow, they attacked me instead of Narset? Well, it just doesn't make any sense. That just can't be right. I mean, I guess they wanna clock me. 12. And I'll do this, and if they have a plow, I draw three cards. I think they'll just concede on this Typhoon. Alright, yeah, I'm pretty happy I kept the spells near DR. That was really key. Alright, good game. Plagueis Blue White Control, so I'll have the three Red Elemental Blast, the two Flash of Storm, the... I don't know. This is five. I'll cut Moat, for sure. So I don't want to have all of these removal spells, but I need to keep some. Maybe I can do something like this. And I'm cutting a land in this matchup. Like a Plains. Or a Caracas. Is Caracas any good? Doesn't work at all with me. Don't think it works with my opponent as well. So yeah, I'll cut Caracas. As this is a fetchable land, I might, you know, end up short of that. So I think I'll Cyberb like this. And yeah, let's go with it. On the draw. Not so good, but I keep. Tundra, uh-huh, not bad. So they might surprise me with a counterbalance on turn two. They play Monster Mentor, so that could be a thing. Meddling Mage. The Spilsner has been a good one. I think I'll go for a Brainstorm here. Looking for a fetch line to have that Red Elemental Blast up. Instead, I do not find it. Okay, so I need a Spellsnare. I need a Sorcery Plowshare to be at least on top of my deck. I guess Red Elemental Blast can go. Since I do not have a way to cast it. Kind of weird when you can't cast your Saber card, but that's fine. I mean, I am pretty sure that there is more than enough sources for it. And now I can jam a Teferi, and I think that's what I'll actually be doing. If I go for some negation, I'll live with that. Or I can cycle a Baby Shark. Actually, that's maybe better. Still will get me one more card to draw for the land drop, because I know the top of the deck is a a bad card. Top of the deck is a... Oh, wow, Sanctuary. I was thinking about Sanctuary in this deck, but, you know, it does make sense as absence. You know, just trying a Sanctuary like this is just pretty awful. Okay, let's see if I draw a fetch land. Nope, I don't. I have seven cards. I think I'll pass one more turn. Casting Teferi into a Force of Negation like this doesn't strike me as a very good play. I think I'll pitch my own Jace. So I'm expecting my opponent to go... here... Red Elemental Blast. And I have to Force of Will again. But I will pitch spells near this time. The two cards in hand. And I'll play Teferi. I think I'll minus three just to draw a card. Nice. Now if they baited me with a second Jace, I have the Red Elemental Blast up. Or if I drew a blue card, I would have had the Force of Negation up. If we're a Mentor, I'm ready with a Plow. I think that's okay. I need to keep a counter for the real threats. Now remember that they cannot counter your spell because we have Teferi Time Raveler in play. They do not shuffle. They do not shuffle there. Counsel Judgment. Yep, I can't do anything about that. But that's fine. Our Planeswalker did its value. Ooh, Standstill. That's nice. I even have the Hall plus Shark Typhoon. This Standstill is gonna draw me three cards here. Oh, actually four, because I also get to counter Red Elemental Blast their Force of Will. And my opponent has pitched a counterbalance, so, you know, my read on their deck was right. Now I have zero cards in, and they know the top two cards with a Ponder. They concede the game, because that's what Standstill does when you're ahead. I mean, I did have the Shark Typhoon plus all of the Hall of Generosity too. Alright, it was a pretty sweet win. Pretty fast, honestly, for an Uvu Control Mirror match. Be back for round number three. Round number three. Unfortunately, I don't have any cantrip. If one of these cards would have been a cantrip, I think I would have kept. Not the Flawless Strand, though. But we have to mulligan this one. A bottom hole of the Helios Generosity. Let's go. Volcanic Island, Ponder, nice. No Delver of Secrets is a good thing. I'm defaulting by thinking they are... Oh, they shuffled, though. All right, hopefully there's a 2-drop on the horizon. Oh, Grove of the Burn Willows, okay. Huh. What's this? Carpet of Flowers, uh-huh. It's funny to see his main deck, Carpet of Flowers, sure. The 2 mana now, let's see what they do with it. Quaddle or Tarmogoyf? And I think I'll slam a Standstill here. Boom. There are not that many lands for a Standstill, but I have 3 Shark Typhoon in my deck. To wait for it. Yeah, ideally now, all you want to do is hit land draw because your opponent will... try to make you go to Discord with the Standstill. So you want to make your land drops. So ideally your opponent casts a spell like a brainstorm or whatever. Ooh, it's happening now. So they cast a brainstorm at the end of my turn. I'm just discarding a card here. Yeah. And it will be either a land or a Supreme Verdict. Or even a cantrip. Yeah, I don't really want to discard a land here. But I play Tarmogoyf, so I don't want to discard Supreme Verdict as well. Okay, you know what? I'm discarding a land. So many cantrips there. I think what I have is enough. Yeah, opponent was kind of like, I think they also needed to hit land drops. So that's why they did that brainstorm there. Okay, that's another Tarmogoyf, that's fine. They pass. I'm just gonna roll a brainstorm here. Brainstorming. Don't know what I'm looking for, though. Ooh, Hall Breacher. Okay, then. I'll play Plow. I have three cards in hand. Okay. Ooh, that's not good. Alright, I'll shuffle away these two, because this is not very strong there. And get a island. I just untap. Play a Ponder. Okay, I like another Standstill. I'll be drawing that one. I'll pass. Ideally, we go Supreme Verdict. Ideally, we go Supreme Verdict. Snapcaster Mage. Uh-huh. We have Caracas for Uro. They don't have a Wasteland. I think I might need to bring in a Rest in Peace for the Punishing Fire. Grove combo. A moat could be almost impossible for my opponent to climb. Maybe. Dark Faden. Okay, I'll counter this. Not necessarily, you know, that powerful, but might as well just use a counter spell. Okay, the Thermal is a 6/7, it's pretty large. Yeah, I'll just go Plains Supreme Verdict here. On top of my deck, there is a Mountain, which I do not want. Get three cards in hand. I chased my Sculptor. I drop the Mountain. I'll also play it. This one will resolve most likely, because my opponent would have definitely fought over the Force of Will if needed. And I decided not to cast Brainstorm, because I'm sure my opponent will have to crack the Standstill eventually. So might as well just hold the brainstorm for when things happen. I'll just yield until on the step, because it's unlikely that they cast anything, so. Okay. Like I said, you wanna hit land drops. It's not 100% true, because you might just, you know, they might just make you pop off despite you go to discard, but that's ideally what you want to do with the Standstill. I guess we're in a spot where they kind of just need to crack it. Regardless. But I think I still keep on making those land drops. There's not really much to say, it's just a waiting game. This deck maybe is a little bit too boring for these legacy videos, but yeah, that's what it is. Okay, there it is. That's the Shark Typhoon that we were looking for. Hitting land drops also makes the Typhoon better, of course. I have 3/5/7, so I'm gonna cycle a 5/5 here. I'll fetch up another Plains, I think. Oh, I don't have another Plains. Alright, then I'll fetch up a Tundra. I'll cycle. Boom. I don't play Team Mirror, so they might not have that many ways to deal with a 5/5. is a couple of bolts, of course. My deck plays a lot of, and this is the combo. It's, you have Standstill down and you cycle the Shard Typhoon. So you just add it to the board while not cracking the Standstill, which is usually how you... Okay, so something is happening. Right, so to begin with, I'll drop three cards. I think my opponent's just lacking of anything relevant here, so I'm just gonna counter this one. Looks like there's a counter war happening. Oh, they are cast a force. Okay, then you can get the Dark Fade in. Yeah. I'll be attacking it next turn. But yeah, Standstill has been pretty huge in this match so far. He drew six cards. So I discard two lands, I have two cards in hand. They play Sylvan Library. Yeah, I have a Narsa ready. I guess I have a Narsa for Dark Fade in as well, honestly. Alright, so let's resolve Narset first. I think I'm gonna keep it there on 5. I'm still killing that. Like, you know, despite I have Narset going, I think it's still like the right play to do. I'm also just casting a Teferi. Pick up and pass. I don't want to take down the Narset because then it dies the Bolt, which my opponent clearly plays. And the Narset just shuts off the Silva Library. I'm already like pretty set up. Or anything I want. Okay, they're about to do something else. They still haven't drawn a Punishing Fire, which of course would be good here. Although I will exile it with the Force of Negation. Yeah, I guess Punishing Fire got a way worse now. I'm gonna play Ponder end of turn just because it's a play that you rarely get to do. So I don't wanna miss that opportunity, you know? I'll go Jace plus REU, whatever card there is, I will leave it on top, even if it's a good one. Bottom, no, you can keep it on top. I'll tick up Teferi, play land, pass the turn. They're very likely going to shuffle. If they don't shuffle, then it's okay. So they draw a Punishing Fire, which I will be Force of Negationing. And they can't answer that, they can't counter my counter, I have a Teferi. And Force of Negation exiles, which is a big difference before Force of Will was pretty ineffective against is definitely ineffective against Punishing Fire. But now the fact that you can exile with the Force of Negation, I think it makes this combo just less good. You can probably unban it in Modern as well. Okay. Playing against another control deck, where I'll be bringing in those, probably from the Ashes as well. Once again, I'm cutting the Moat. I just feel like that in this matchup, you know, maybe my opponent doesn't have that, but they showed me Jace, the Mind Sculptor. So like, yeah, I mean, I think Moat is like a cool main deck card to cheese out some decks. But overall, I think you shouldn't like be keeping in the main deck too much. Yeah, I think I'll board out all the plows. I'll keep it super in verdict. Spellsnare has been nice. Maybe I can cut Counterspell. Maybe I can cut Counterspell here. Then got one Jace. Yeah, because I'm bringing it from the Ashes. Alright, let's go with this. Game number two with a pretty land heavy hand, but I'm okay with it. Wow, Brainstorm, such a perfect draw. You don't need to cast it. I'm not really looking for much right now. Just chilling. Silver Library, okay. It's a good start. I have some Kamsu Judgment for that, but. It will definitely be a good start here. I don't have my Spellsnare. My trusty Spellsnare. Oh wow, they just lost 8 immediately. See? Mm-hmm. It's gonna be a tough start to beat. Just, you know. basically stands still, that keeps on doing stuff even after he's dead. Let me see if they shuffled. They didn't. Yeah, I'm not gonna brainstorm here. Just keep on making land drops. Predict, huh? Right, this is a nice setup. No need to rush, no need to cast my cantrips, just hit land drops and pass it back. Alright, I'll be casting a Red Lamenta Blast there. The combo with Punishing Fire is pretty real. I don't want them to do it. Eventually, I can go Brainstorm Predict with the Flusters from backup. By eventually, I mean it could actually be this end step if they tap out, but if they tap out, I guess we have to answer with a Brainstorm. Three mana, that's another Duck Faden. I think I'll go ahead and brainstorm in response. Okay, do something like this. I can brainstorm again. I'm looking for that Red Lamenta Blast. Oh, actually, I think I've fetched the wrong land, because now I can't cast Counseling Judgment. Alright, whatever. Okay, I didn't really find what I want to. So, in upkeep, I'm going to play Predict. What is the card that I want to mill out of those? Maybe I want to mill a Flusters Storm. Yeah, maybe I want to mill a Flusters Storm here. I don't mind having land drops, so yeah. I'll go like this. So Dark Fader resolves. I don't have two Tundra, that's why I'm saying that they tapped in a way where maybe they boarded out Punishing Fire. Or maybe they wanted to have all the Flusters Storms up. Nope, they discarded Punishing Fire. So yeah, that's a little combo my opponent's doing. Upkeep Predict. I'll name Flusters Storm. And draw two cards, draw for turn. I could technically tap out to exile this deck. Huh. That's risky though, right? But, like, they can just Flusters Storm me, and that's bad. I kind of want Exalted Dock though. Okay, so now I'm fully tapped out on my turn, which isn't a great place to be, but I think I had to. Alright, so this is the second dock going. Not a Punishing Fire. You know, at least they won't do that amount of value. Alright, it took four, so there aren't eight life. I think I'm gonna just slow roll this Shark Typhoon until they take four more and just randomly die to my EOT Shark. It is blue, so they can't Red Lamenta Blast it, but we'll see. Okay, what's this now? A Narset? Jace, okay. And they keep on brainstorming, keep on accruing value. Oh, they go to no one have six cards, sorry. Okay. On top draw. Spells there. What am I doing now? I think I'll just again counsel judgment. And pass the turn. If I draw from the ashes, that's gonna be a back breaking play, I think. Opponent is on 7. They have made +3 with Sylvan Library, and I made +1 with the Predict. You know, we aren't that far away off each other. Considering that, you know, I guess they made also +1 with Jace. Pretty good. Forest. Yeah, I'm happy that they're drawing all these basics. That's gonna make my From the Ashes much better. Clothus. Oh, that one cannot resolve. Oh wow, it didn't. Is this a bait? It was. Alright, sure. Jace. Mm-hmm. More brainstorms. I can't cast Shark Typhoon in this matchup. There's right on the blasts. Hole is a nice one. I think I'm shuffling Ponder away actually here. I guess I don't have to shuffle necessarily. Yeah, I think I'll just redraw. Nah, you know what? I just need to find a Red Elemental Blast, I feel like. Or I can just... I think I'm casting Standstill, actually, here. Yeah, I just changed my mind. It looked to me like they F6. Although, Red Elemental Blast does kill Jace, which is nice. Yeah, I think I'm gonna play Standstill. They can go like Punishing Fire twice to kill my Jace. I do have a Force. And they have spells near. Yeah, actually, I think I changed my mind once again. I'll just put on top Force and Standstill. Maybe it's Shark Typhoon and Standstill. And I'll cast a Red Elemental Blast. Yeah. Shark Typhoon, Standstill, and then Red Elemental Blast on the Jace. This game is tense. And I pass. And I have Spells Nair for the Punishing Fire on the second time. And I have Flash of Storm in case something goes... and I have Force of Incense in case something goes wrong. Lots of options here. On top of the deck, there's two very good cards. The combination, in fact. Standstill plus Shark Typhoon. Oh yeah, that's fine. What has been cantripping a lot? They have 7 cards in it. I mean, they're gonna go up to, down to 5, but they have a lot of cards in it. I'm pretty happy with how this game played out, honestly. Don't just rush, you know? If they have a single library, don't just, you know, completely, furiously. Like, it's just some card advantage, you know? I know it sounds like, stupid, but it's just some card advantage. It's just like resolving an Ancestral Recall. Planeswalkers, Clothus. It's where I think you have to be worried about. So this is Storm Count 3. This is Storm Count 3. If I go Force of Will, I'm gonna be, yeah, I think I'll go Force. I was thinking about they would have fought over it. But it goes Snapcaster. Oh, that's fine. It's very much fine. Then I go Flash of Storm, and they can only fight it back with another Flash of Storm. No other counter will work. They have 3 cards in hand, and they... I don't know if they return this Punishing Fire. They did. Alright, so now I'll just begin the turn by casting Standstill. Nice. And then I'll play a Brainstorm. And I'll pass. Maybe those shoes are just plus two Jace. I don't know. Here I can cast Shark Typhoon for three. I can't blow it up with a Punishing Fire. That requires them six mana. They pay two mana and play Petty Theft. Okay. That's powerful. Oh, a Force of Will. It's nice. And since I have the whole of the Heliod's Generosity plus Shark Typhoon, I'm going to keep a standstill in hand rather than a ponder. Okay, looks like they're casting their own Force. Fine. Then I'll draw a card off the cycling. That will also, before that, kill my Jace, looks like. That's where that I waited. Okay. I'm inclined to just put on top the Shark Typhoon now. Oh, actually, no, it's fine. I can just put the Shark Typhoon now. Yeah. Yeah, I guess I should do it. Put on top Shark Typhoon now, draw it, play land, play standstill. And I can just do that every turn. Yeah, this land is pretty crazy. In this spot, I think. The attack, I just cycle a 1-1 shark and block. Okay, looks like we're going to draw three cards here with an Uro. Yeah, I guess I'll fetch first. Yeah, I did a classic fetch to thin, ended up just drawing the last two basics of my deck. Which is something. I'll pour some water in my glass. I could have brought in some. I didn't even draw a rack, it's just straight up lands. It really sucks here. Okay, so that's an Uro. 24 cards left in my deck. They have a Punishing Fire in their graveyard. Oh, they didn't have a land left. Okay. So I'll Breacher, I don't draw a card. A Breacher said it only draws them, so it just doesn't work, like, at all. Right. I have a couple of Supreme Verdict left. So from the ashes. I don't think Red Elemental Blast does much. But from the ashes, I can blow up their entirety of lands, but I can also blow up my Hollows of the Heliod's Generosity. So I think I just have to get Red Elemental Blast, kill the whole Breacher. Pretty awkward, but yeah, Hulk Breacher is very annoying here. The fact that it stops my, you know, Shark Typhoon on top thing. Okay, so now they don't draw a card off of Uro, but they will kill my Narset, I'm assuming. Narset top deck was nice. I mean, it comes after three lands, so it's not deck. Tarmogoyf, yeah. That's big. That's very big. The Punishing Fire on the graveyard and Brazen. Oh, wow. Am I dead on board? I think I might be. Do I want to put something on top? Let's make a 1-1 shark. Or 3-3 shark. No, I think I just have to top deck Supreme Verdict or bust. Supreme Verdict. And then I pass the turn. Alright, that was lucky. But again, it came after like drawing a lot of land, so at the end of the day we have 21 cards in our deck, and there were two Supreme Verdict. So it wasn't that bad. I could have put on top Shark Typhoon and draw regardless, but my top deck with the arrows that in case I draw like a Jace and I need to pay 4 to play a cantrip, 4 to play the Supreme Verdict, I didn't have enough mana, so that's why I just figured I need to top deck. Like, sometimes you should just find yourself in those spots where you just actually need to top deck. Alright, well, you might have noticed how in the previous game my microphone just unplugged for some reason by itself. So, and I did the whole game 3 of this beautiful match by talking to no one because the microphone wasn't recording. So I'm going to do the over record of the match that just right now happened, so my brain is perfectly, I remember every play, right? I mean, I hope so. Okay, so anyway, let's go. Keep, easy keep, rest in peace, it's nice, and all I want to do now is just to preserve and make sure that rest in peace resolve here. So I'm going to fight over it with a force of will if my opponent goes force. Rest in peace is just incredible in this matchup. It was a huge mistake not bringing it in game 2. But I didn't really know what my opponent deck was doing. So now that I know, I am happy that I brought in Rest in Peace. It stops Uro, Tarmogoyf, Kolothis, and Punishing Fire. All these cards are the card that I see. So here I top deck Standsteel, which is great. But I also need to make land drops. So first I play Ponder, hoping to get a land. And then boom, that's the Rest in Peace. That's the Standsteel. Which, as we saw before, my opponent will make sure to pop off when I am going to discard. That's an important thing. When you play against Standsteel, you have to play a Brainstorm at their end of the turn when they have like 7 cards in hand, so they get to discard all of them, which is one of the reasons why Standsteel is sometimes not a great card. Anyway, here I have 6 cards in hand, which is a lot. My opponent is not doing anything, so that's fine. I draw land, which I'm very happy with, and boom, they pop off the Standsteel with a Brainstorm end of turn. And I'm going to cast Red Elemental Blast here, since, you know, I'm going to discard the card anyway. So, might as well play it on the Brainstorm. Last card I discard is Brainstorm, since I already have 8 cards in it. No need to do anything. I don't fight over cantrips. All I have to fight is Real Threat. And Kolothis, let me tell you, it's not a real threat, because there's Rest in Peace in play, so it does straight up nothing. Tarmogoyf, same deal. I feel so good right now. I feel like I can't lose this game. I play Narset, looking for, a Shark Typhoon, I guess. Oh, actually, let me pause this 1 second. I don't know if you saw it, on Narset, there was a Shark Typhoon and a Force of Will. I actually thought a lot there. And ended up taking Force of Will, because I figured, the only way I lose this game is if my opponent manages to kill the Rest in Peace with, I don't know what, a Natural Claim or whatever. So all I have to do is make sure that I have Force of Wills for this Rest in Peace. Everything else will find on its own. So I did say that I wanted to find a Shark Typhoon with this Narset, but you know, at the end, I prefer a Force of Will here. Okay, let's move on. They are just desperately looking for something, but they can't because they have a Narset. Alright, so they go Petty Theft, I go Spells in Air, they go Force, I go Flusterstorm on the Petty Theft. That's important, because if you Flusterstorm the original copy of Petty Theft, they basically can't counter back, because Flusterstorm is multiple copies on the same one. So that threat is solved, and they keep on not doing anything. Remember, Kolothis requires cards to target, and there's nothing to target. Tarmogoyf is a 0-1. Rest in Peace completely takes over this game. They go Punishing Fire on my Narset. That's fine, it's no big deal. Punishing Fire, it's exiled, so it doesn't work with Grove. And yeah, I feel like great. I don't need to do anything with my Narset. Basically, I'm acting like a prison deck. My opponent is just imprisoned. They don't draw extra cards with Uro because they have a Narset in play. They can't flash anything back because they have a Rest in Peace in play. So they're just locked out. Eventually, I draw a Jace or a Shark Typhoon and I'll take the game over. But until then, no need to rush. Just slowly pausing this game. It's a pretty big mistake not to bring in Rest in Peace in game number two, but you know, thankfully there's plenty of room for mistake in best of three, as you can sideboard. There you go, Pyroblast. I don't fight over that, no need to. I'm still like chilling. The Teferi wouldn't have done much anyway, so no need to do anything. End of turn, I play Snapcaster Mage, which I immediately kill with Plow. I don't want to let them kill my Narset with the Snapcaster Mage attack. Sylvan Library doesn't do anything. I have a Narset in play. Doc Faden, that's fine. They have zero cards in hand. They can draw extra cards. They just stick up on them. I draw Brainstorm, which finds really just the best I could have think of, which is a Shark Typhoon, Rhadamanthal Blast, Rhadamanthal Blast. And it's funny how they have so many permanents, but none of them do anything. So now I will cycle this Shark Typhoon over here, make a 5-5 with a forceful backup, and the game ends right now. My opponent saying, I hope this ends up in a video, and I said it is, and then I realized that. By the way, this second video over it lasts exactly the half of the previous one. the original video lasted 12 minutes, and this lasts 6. So yeah, the repeat on these is good. Alright, we're gonna back to the normal videos. This was just an over video because my microphone didn't work, but hopefully from now on I will have no issue whatsoever. Round number 4. Hopefully we don't play another hour game, our match this time around. My hand though, we do have the combo stance, the Shark Typhoon. But yeah, I don't have that much interaction if the opponent actually plays threats. Okay, I'll go for a Ponder here. Looking for a Force. Tropical Island. Spell Pierce. Disrupt. What? Wow. This is a next level Spore Spike. My opponent must feel so smart right now. My opponent must feel so smart right now. Kinda jealous. that's a good draw. I think I just fire off immediately. Do you wanna play around Daze? Yeah, I just play a Plow. To play around Daze a little bit. Please, Tundra Hold, don't wasteland it. And if my Tundra holds and they just pass, I'll just play a standstill pretty happily. With my Hall of the Heliod's Generosity. No, that's a wasteland. Okay. It's a Delver. But I want to cast a standstill here. The Delver is going to flip. If I don't hit land drops quick enough and they wasteland me, I'm not able to make a Shark Typhoon 2-2. Yeah, maybe it's just better if I don't do anything past the turn and then end of turn I'll play a Brainstorm. Because I will need to hit my land drops. If there was like 3 lands, if I had like a third land in hand, they would have played the standstill here. Because like worst case scenario, they say, you know, it's not a big deal. But the fact that the standstill can be turned against me if I never draw a fourth land, it's just too risky. Maybe it isn't. maybe it isn't that risky, and I should just go for it. Because I'm on 19. The Delver will flip, because they just brainstormed. I know it's super risky, right? But at the end of the day, I have 21 lands. And I just need to draw two. And I need them not to have a wasteland. I think, so, it's possible that this doesn't work, and I lose the game to that Delver. But it's also possible that I just don't win anyway. With two standstill in my hand, it's also possible that one. It's also possible my opponent dazes, or forces, or whatever, because they're afraid. And if that happens, then it's great, you know? I'm happy that I traded the standstill for whatever they had. I think here I have to take a little bit of a risk in order to win this game on the draw against a Delver deck. You know, I'm playing against the tier 1 and I'm on the draw. So I think that you have to take a little bit of risks. And they also just disrupt me on turn 1, an actual disrupt. They flipped a fork, a bolt, and they have a land in hand. So their hand is four cards. One is a fork bolt, one is a land that they returned with the days. Sick. That's fine. They have made the land drop, so they can't. Tempted to force, but I will not. Oh, I drop lanes. Do I want to go for it again? Just cast a standstill again? And maybe if I force this. Alright, here I just cast a brainstorm instead. Okay. What am I planning on doing here? I think I want to cast a standstill once again. Just top two lands here. Because of the Hall of the Helios Generosity. I mean, of course, if they wasteland, it's a disaster. But I can handle with Shark Typhoon the two Delver one at a time. Here I go to 10. Then I'll cycle Shark Typhoon, block 1, go to 7. Then I can put a Shark Typhoon on top, go to 4. And then I can block again, stay on 4. So I can technically survive through the standstill. Yeah, I mean, there's no way I'd put any stop if they have a Stifle for my Shark Typhoon. It's tough. I mean, I guess I was supposed to draw planes instead of island in case I, you know, draw like two planes in a row with the cycle effect and they crack my standstill. So yeah, that's a minor mistake. Unlikely that will matter, but I should have put a planes on top of my deck with the brainstorm and then island. Might not be a minor mistake at all if they bolt this shark here and I draw four cards and they don't have double white to play Supreme Verdict. I just lose the game because of that. Okay, it looks like they'll let me block, which is exactly what I wanted to happen. So, all good. They pass the turn. That's fine. As I said, I mean, everything is going according to plan, honestly. I got a 4. And then I put on top the Shark Typhoon and draw it, and then I have a blocker for Delver. With one mana spare to pay for the days to the force. I mean obviously the line is it's going exactly how I planned it. That doesn't mean that I'm winning. Anyway, do I wanna cast a Shark Typhoon now? 2/2. That will make my opponent double the mana, because they can go bolt end of turn and then fork it bolt in their turn. double the red mana that way, so it's better if I don't do anything. And just Shark Typhoon's main phase, because Forky Bolt is a sorcery. If they bolt me end of turn, I hope I can draw a plow. But yeah, certainly an interesting game. Yeah, I'm happy. I'm happy to showcase this kind of game plan. It is taking a while, and this is definitely a long legacy video, but you know, once in a while, I think it's worth it. And with the YouTube X2 speed, you can get through this. You know, the replay are sometimes nice because they take slower, but you maybe don't get in the mind as I'm playing it. It is not an easy game. I put it also deep in the tank. I think this will be the last match, by the way. I think this will be the last match. This is already being a pretty long video. Didn't have a plan against a single combo deck, so I really made it very long. Alright, so we draw three. I'll play a brainstorm. Okay. So, I have to force. Then I have to Shark Typhoon for a 2-2 block the Delver. And then, yeah, I mean, that's the plan here, right? What am I hiding? Like, if I force, I go to 3. Force of Negation costs me 0 life, thankfully. So I can technically, yeah, I guess I cannot ever fetch anymore. I guess it's whatever, right? No, I mean, I go to 3. Okay, I just have to top the good cards. Card that I don't... Honestly, it just doesn't matter. I'm topping, for sure, land, because whatever. I think another good card here is Supreme Verdict. And of course, pitching one spell's near. I basically have to like use this all, I think. I can't use Force of Negation. Because then I die to the Delver attack. If they fight over this... Okay. Okay, we're alive here. Shark Typhoon lets me chum block the Delver. Then it can double Force of Negation the Fork of Bolt. I mean, up to double Force of Negation to Fork of Bolt. And Shark Typhoon will let me draw the Flood of Strand and the Supreme Verdict, so I can cast Supreme Verdict. I kind of hope that my opponent just casts the creature now, like a Tarmogoyf. That would be the dream. Because then I go down to 2 life with a fetch land. And then I can just counter this Forkable, because this is a sorcery. Forkable is a sorcery. Opponent shuffled their deck with Ponder. What a tense game. Okay. They know I had a Shark Typhoon, so. I guess that's why they did the daze. Because they know that this way I have to chum block. Maybe looking for Bolt. But I'll let them do the brainstorm. Like, they've already made a land drop, I'm pretty sure. Yeah, they played a tropical island already. I'm hoping they don't find a bolt, but they just find like another Delver. Maybe they might play around like Terminus or something. Okay. Okay, so they don't have a bolt. So I am chump blocking here. That's three life. Do they fork and bolt me? If they do, I have to force a negation. Plus strength for planes. They have three cards in hand. I can make another 1/1 Shark Typhoon next turn. X Drinker. I'll have six. Disrupt again, jeez. Okay, I have to top the Typhoon here. And draw. Weird that they didn't level this up though. Guess I'm passing, no need to do it now. I mean, if they draw our sorcery speed removal, I'll probably just die regardless. I guess I'm just passing. Yeah, I don't need to do this now. Guess the only need is if they draw Stifle, but. Wow. Just go to combat? Guess they have a bolt. Yeah, I guess if I draw. If I draw my turn a blue card. I can counter a bolt if they top deck it. Or Petty Theft. Alright, let's see if I draw. What good can I draw? Yeah. Had I done this in my turn? I mean, I guess they had a Brazen Bard the whole time. That's why they didn't pump it. Because they were playing around me just doing exactly this play. Alright, cool game. Cool game. I mean, I got disrupted twice. That felt bad. It's a card I didn't even know, honestly. All right, I'll bring in this. Let's bring in Rest in Peace again. Right? They must have Clothis. They must have Tharmogoyf. They must have Uros. Sure. Once again, I got Moat. I mean, I keep on playing against these Brazen Bard decks. I swear, there is also other decks. Some cutting counter spells. One Jace. Is From the Ashes even good? Maybe, actually, it's not that bad. I'm gonna keep all the standstill in this matchup. Can cut maybe one spell in there. Alright, let's go. Game two on the play. Let's keep this hand. I'll try to not get under the. I guess From the Ashes is good enough. Maybe better than Jace. Maybe. It's kind of weird that I have a red card in hand and I keep on playing lands that can't cast it. The thing is that there isn't like Ancestral Recall in Legacy. You know, it's not a card that you have to counter. Red Elemental Blast is mainly there for Delver. Or just in the late game as a counter magic to protect your threats or, you know, to protect your counter and stuff like that. So that's the reason why I just don't even want to expose the Flood of Strength Volcanic Island. It's just, I'm not gonna do that. Oh wow, they missed the land drop and go to discard? Nice. Don't cast anything. Just let them go to discard. Don't cast anything, just let them go to discard. I kept the one lander on the draw, which is totally reasonable. You cast Brainstorm on turn 2 to maximize the chances of the chances of drawing a... Alright, so here I think here I want to cast Brainstorm. Shuffling away a Supreme Verdict and what else? Maybe a Shark Typhoon? Maybe a Brainstorm? Next time I'm certainly going to cast, I cast now Rattle Metal Blast. Yeah, I guess it's Brainstorm that I don't want. I'm gonna kill the Delver. Untap, draw, ponder. Yeah, looking for a land here. Wow, I'm missing a land drop too. Maybe not. Pass. I might cycle this 0/0 Typhoon end of turn. All right, I'll counter. Maybe my opponent will force of will this. They do. Pitching Stifle. Okay. Let's see what they do with a ponder. With this ponder. They don't shuffle. It's a Volcanic Island and the passing of the turn. I keep on passing here. Uro costs 4 mana to return, so I don't have that much pressure. Sylvan Library. Yep. Unfortunately, I wasn't able to capitalize on my opponent's early stumblings. I could have forced that ponder, but the thing is that they're gonna draw this card regardless. You know, it's not that these two Volcanic Island disappear. If they're on top of the deck before after the ponder, they're also there after the ponder. If the ponder doesn't resolve, I mean. I should really stop missing land drop though. You know, this doesn't really help me. It's kind of crazy because we played 21 lands and I kept 3 lands in my opening end. So here, What to do? If I cast a standstill and they daze, I'm okay. If they cast a standstill on end of turn, I do something. It's less okay because I have to go to discard big time. I think I'm shuffling here. Just need to let my land drop. Fuck. A tap pass, I guess. It's really unfortunate, but it's okay, I guess. That's how it has to go down. Okay, so they have mana to return to Uro. We do have a plow for that. They might not expect a rest in peace. But next turn I'll play it. I've been waiting too long, I think. Shuffle, okay. Ponder shuffled, interesting. They might have Old Breacher. Maybe Arcast the Force of Negation. Red Elemental Blast. I still don't want to cast a Rest in Peace under these. So, you know, if they return Uro, I guess I'll just plow it. Petty Theft. I don't want to lose my shark because it's actually something, you know, relevant. They have a silver library. You know, I might have just played the Force of Will on the least relevant threat so far, but I basically never wanted to cast my Force into Red Elemental Blast Mana, which maybe make you think, why don't you sideboard it out then? Yeah, that's a good point. That's a good point. Let's see if they bring back Uro. I mean, just being like, okay, that's fine. A classic Magic player that, you know, gets slightly unlucky with these, like, land and then just start playing badly. Just blaming the Varians. Alright, land. Oh, nice. Die. Now the rest in, I'm gonna fight with Teeth and, how do you say, Teeth and Claw or this Rest in Peace, because this one stops the Clothis and the Uro. Nice. Nice, nice, nice. This is, oh wow. Wow. Stifle. Okay. Okay. Okay, we can do this. Opponent goes to 7. Their Clothis is shut off. Their library is always working. I have another Typhoon here. I might have played my entire game around Daze, and my opponent doesn't have Daze in their deck plus sideboard against me. Anyway, they pass here. Nice. I'll attack with Shark. Shark attack. You know, I could have had Brazen Bomb. I'm just happy I used my Force on the Brazen Bomb. I mean, it also went well, so of course I'm happy. They're fetching in my upkeep before using the library, and I think I'm just making a 2/2 shark here. Two plains, two islands. Before they can draw a stifle for my 2/2. Nice. Okay, so now they're on 5, and they see the top cards with library, but my clock is there. My opponent only took damage by themselves with the library, and attacked very few times with the shark, with a 1/1 shark. So yeah, it's not that free, the library thing. Wow, we win this game. That's incredible. If at any point it would have brought back Uro, it would have been a disaster. They would have gained 9 life between my Plow and their Uro. Yeah, I'm just so blessed that this game went in my favor, really. Like, they got an early mana screw, but I also didn't do anything at the beginning because I didn't have any more lands to play around their days, which they didn't have. Crazy. So, do I want to have some From the Ashes? I think I want to board out Jace. I think From the Ashes is better than Jace. Maybe Narset also isn't good. Actually, I think I want to all the Force of Negations. Maybe not. Maybe Flask Scrim is better. Spells never to answer library, I think I need them all. And Flask Scrim is just important to answer Red Elemental Blasts. Yeah, let's go with this. Final game of this video. This is just the round 4, but you know, this has really lasted a lot. And what do we do now? Okay, I'm happy I drew that one because I didn't want to play dual land against the deck with Wastelands. And if they cast a library, my spells never is ready. Let's see. Tropical Island Ponder, sure. Let's see if they kept one land or a brick again, like the previous game. That really gave me the chance. They shuffle their library with Ponder. Do they have a land? Wasteland, they don't have a land! Man, it's so unlucky. It's kind of unlucky also that I drew the that I drew only dual my only two dual lands of the deck. Alright, am I just lambing rest in peace? No. Play Volk. I have like mono white hand, so if I don't want to waste on my Volk, it's okay with me. Best case scenario is they tap these two lands to the library. Wow, that's multiple wastelands. Really sad news for my... for my... two dual lands hand. Alright, that's the flames. That's good. That's good. Mm-hmm. Brainstorm's okay. Let's see if I find a fetch land to get out of the lock. Because Ponder lets you, you don't get Ponder blocked. You never heard about that. You can get Brainstorm locked. And wow, like they are right now. Because they didn't draw... they didn't draw a thing. They got a discard here. They discard Uro. Mm-hmm. And a pass here. I don't want to move. They're going to... Alright. Sure. They're going to discard again here. So, I don't want to do anything that makes them go like Force of Will or, you know, cast a Stifle or anything. I just want to let them discard of end size. And gain, like, sort of card advantage this way because they discarded two cards and I've never discarded so far. I could have fetched at some point to play around the Stifle, but you know, like... okay, so here I can also discard. Or I can just force their Stifle. And just cast the Rest in Peace. Now that I drew a Force of Will, I'm happier to do so. Pitching... Pitching Supreme Verdict. And I'll cast a Rip. Rip. If they Force of Will, that's okay. I'll live with that. If not, we've seen the power of Rest in Peace against this Tinger decks. This is the Exile Zone, remember? Yep. To replay their Brainstorm. I've just been very, very lucky in this match. Wow, it bricked again. Man. I guess it's just... If you disrupt your opponent twice in game one, you're just bound to get unlucky in the next two games. Maybe that's like a secret rule. I'll just cycle a 2-2 Shark Typhoon now that my opponent stepped out. They will, like, there's no way I can Spellsnare anything because my opponent is Brainstorm locked. So they're not going to cast a 2-drop. So might as well just make sure that I got a 2-2 around their Stifle now. Okay, so Ponder, not Shuffle, alright. So they're out of the lock here slightly. They discarded an Ur of End Size and a Disrupt. They also wastelanded twice my few lands. Alright, here I started beating with this Typhoons. Sorry, with the Sharks. No Typhoons. Typhoons are just going in the graveyard in this matchup. In the against Green White Reclaimer in the first round, I casted Typhoon a lot, and I even joked about it on Twitter. But now the dance changed. Hey, I'm not gonna cycle now. I think Spell Pierce might actually be irrelevant here. If they bolt my shark, that's okay. Okay, that's another land. I don't want to cycle Shark Typhoon. I'm playing around Petty Theft by leaving up mana for Dispel Snares. Yeah, I'm not casting Brainstorm either. Just let it go. I have 7 cards and then no need to cast any. I think it's a Petty Theft coming in end of turn. Or at least that's what I'm expecting. And I have double spells there for it. Playing around Everett Disrupt, the one I cast on me. With this Plows, with this Plains. Yep. On the Rest in Peace, interesting. Not on the Shark. Okay. I mean, I certainly act here. I don't want them to, like, you know, resolve my Rest in Peace. We've seen how strong it's been so far. And I'm not even playing against Spell Pierce or Flash of Storm. I just Plow end of turn. Only playing around Disrupt and Daze. Wow, do they have Daze and Disrupt here? My day do? Oh no, they double this. Okay, then it's fine, you know. As long as I don't get disrupted, it's fine. So they have 2 traps in hand, and I'm okay with that. I'll play Ponder. Ooh, this is good. I'll play a Standstill here. Nice. And I'm attacking. Twelve to 16. I have a second Shark Typhoon to easily win this race. They flip with Pyroblast. That's good to know. That might kill one of these sharks. I mean, I'd say that the plan is working. The Rest in Peace Standstill plan is working, but of course it's working because my opponent was Brainstorm locked both game 2 and 3. I don't know if, like, under normal circumstances, how the matchup really is. Not that my opponent deck is, like, playing, like, some weird card, but overall, their deck is a Ruck Delver. Stifle, it's very popular these days because you can combo with Uro. You know, 4 mana, you can just cast Uro. But that's never been a play that I'm a fan of. I really hate the card Stifle in Legacy. It's never liked it, and I would never like it. You know, it's fine if, you know, if I get got, it's all cool and everything. But I was just no way I like that card. Okay, opponent's passing here, and it's okay with me. I'll play Prismatic Beast and attack for 2 here, and they block. Mm-hmm. I'll draw another land here before cycling this Shark Typhoon. That way my Shark Typhoon is a 4-4. I'll play around Bolt. I'll tutor up Mountain with this Vista. Then I can cast from the Ashes if I want to. Along the way. And of course the 3 Red Elemental Blasts. This mana base reminds me so much of old Miracles. I don't know if you also guys get that vibe. Of this mana base right here. Oh wow, I'm drawing 3 cards. Sweet. Oh, the combo. Okay, no 4/4 from Mangu, but just 1 card. I guess 4 cards. Rest in peace, numero dos. Alright, I'll play Brainstorm first. Sorry, I meant Ponder. Ooh. This is all good, but I will just lead on with a Shuffler. Nope. I'll lead off with a Standstill. Oh, they have a Power Blast in hand, I forgot about it. I guess I can go Brainstorm and force that, or I can just let it go, because whatever. I don't know what's on top. What's on top? Forced brainstorm? Clothis. Would love to cast Clothis with Rest in Peace in play. I think that just... Oh, wow, I forgot. This doesn't work as well. Lol. All right, that's funny. Okay, never mind. All right, so I draw that one. I'll brainstorm. I think I'm shuffling away Rest in Peace and Constant Judgment. Yeah, Hall of Diglio's Generosity probably should have not been here. Let's see if I find it from the Ashes. I don't have 26 cards in my deck. Am I running out of threats? Wait, I just realized that one. That I only have one Shark Typhoon left in my deck that can attack. And it boarded out to every Jace. So I guess I have to keep the Shark Typhoon very close to me. 24 cards in my deck. I have more time, so I can win on time as well, maybe. Let's keep on hitting land drop. I mean, I have 23 cards. There's two from the Ashes. Sylvan Library. I guess I'll cast this Force of Will. I just realized I was lacking win condition. I thought it was all good, but no, the hold doesn't work with Rest in Peace. Okay, that's a standstill. It's not good. No, it's not very good. Yeah, doesn't my opponent do? Just I guess I'm in. Honestly, I'm just waiting to draw the Shark Typhoon, so might as well just stall the game until that happens. You know, my opponent has 5 cards in hand. That's a lot of cards. And if they pop the standstill end of turn, sure, I'll discard some extra cards. Make all these land drops, even though they don't even find a single card. Is that the Volcan Tundra are in the graveyard, and this deck plays, I believe, 5 islands. I mean, winning on time is a thing. I have 2 minutes more than my opponent, and sure, I have 19 cards. I believe they can't let me draw 19 cards, and if they just F6 until the end. But I guess it's like if I find one Shark Typhoon, I think I'm able to protect that shark. I don't know honestly if I can. All right, so I'll discard. I think I'll discard. Brainstorm. I have 18 cards. Yeah, they also got a discard. Yeah, I'll discard to predict here. Maybe I can make my opponent deck with the predict and the standstill. Not right. That's just way too many cards. Okay, they decide to make this play. Interesting. I draw 3. No Shark Typhoon. Oh, let me count how many islands I have in my deck. 5. Yeah. So no more lands for these fetch lands. Okay, they'll take their last land. I haven't even drawn the Armageddon. Huh, isn't it crazy? 13 cards, there's 2. There's 2 in it. I kind of get. Oh, wow. Oh, X Drinker? Sure. This can only be leveled up as a sorcery. So I just wait until they put the third one to play a plow. Also have a Teferi to bounce it in case. But yeah, so first step is going to be to find the From the Ashes. And then the Shark Typhoon. After I'll have make my opponent run out of lands to play any spell with. Why did I play this league? Alright, so here it is, a plow. The Force Pitch Uro. Little Summer. I'll Force the Veil. Then another Force, have a Elemental Blast, as well as a Plow. Yeah, I think I'll win on time as well before finding the win condition. Yeah. Time is a legitimate win condition. I mean it's technically if the Shark Typhoon is literally the last card of my deck, then it can go badly, but this is kind of now I wanted to take a screenshot, but that's fine. Alright, so this all worked. I just have six. On top. Draw. Stand still. I'll play it to Teferi first. Dig up. Then I'll play a Brainstorm. Shuffle these two. Blow up every land they have. Yes. Yeah, here's the card I'm looking for. I don't know if they have any land left, but I doubt it. And I'll pass the turn. They have 22 cards in their deck. Not gonna play Standstill. Will I find a Shark Typhoon? Or will I die of decking first? We'll have to discard. Okay, I'll discard this. Typhoon. Okay, I'll play a Brainstorm. Oh no. I'll put on top whatever these two here. Then I will shuffle the deck. Play a Ponder. No. Come on. Oh. I have five cards left. One of them is a Typhoon. Come on, Typhoon. Terrible. Terrible death. Terrible death. If I don't find a single, I don't find my card. After a Bracer and a Ponder too. See. So here, what I want to do is I'll cast the Typhoon. I have three cards in my deck, huh? Now I want to play Red Elemental Blast. Remember, they can't cast any force because they have Teferi. I'll play Red Elemental Blast and I'll force it. Then I'll untap. And I'll play Council Judgment. They might still have a Tropical Island left in their deck. But yeah. So now I'll hold full control. Red Elemental Blast the Teferi. And force it. Now I'll Council Judgment. And I have two cards in my deck, so I'll attack. And then I'll win the turn after. If they Red Elemental Blast my Shark, I'm still able to Red Elemental Blast their Fairy. GG, they said. Oof, they said, wasn't sure if you could kill me. That's actually a good point, because I only had one Typhoon left. Classic Mango running out low on win condition. That's always a thing I love to do whenever I play Magic, whether it's Cube, whether it's Legacy Vintage. All right. Ooh. That was a good one. That was a good league. I'm hoping you guys had fun. So we lost the first round, but then we rattled back and 3-1. Yeah. Oof. Be back for another Legacy video next time. I'll submit here. Thanks for watching. If you did like this video, press like and follow the channel, Firewall YouTube channel.